CYP2C9 is important in the pharmacokinetic pathway of warfarin. So let's learn a bit more about how it goes from gene to protein. CYP2C9 can be found on chromosome 10 of the human genome. Chromosome 10 is about 135 million base pairs long, and the CYP2C9 gene can be found towards the end of the chromosome. The CYP2C9 gene itself contains 9 exons spanning more than 50,000 base pairs of DNA. After transcription and splicing, the resulting mRNA contains 1,473 nucleotides of coding region between the start and stop codons. And then after translation, you end up with a protein that has 490 amino acids. There's one allele of the CYP2C9 gene that's associated with enhanced warfarin efficacy and potential toxicity. And you can see that allele here, the change from an adenine to a cytosine at position 1,075. Now, using the genetic code we learned about in lesson 3, and which you can find in the instructor's notes on this page, I want you to determine the change expected in the amino acid sequence here, and then select the type of mutation that best categorizes the cytosine allele. If you have trouble answering this, go back and review mutations from lesson 6.